Yukon is a dangerous place. You never know what's coming. I came up here because I didn't want to be around anyone. And then I met Buck. He was a dog like no other. He'd been spoiled.
Out! Come on, Buck!
And he'd suffered.
Come on!
But he could not be broken.
I don't know where you came from, but I know where you are now. Welcome to the last place on the earth.
I should let him have a minute. Doesn't look like he's ever seen snow before. How do you feel about an adventure beyond all maps?
We could go, you and I.
Where no one's ever been before. See what's out there.
I'm glad you're enjoying this.
I never saw him believe in anything as much as he believes in you.
What do you say, Buck? Adventure of a lifetime. You've been sleeping for 2 days. In my bed.
Hey, welcome to AMC's Thursday Ticket. I am Ryan, and I am here with Kelley.
That is cute. You almost forgot your name. It's a good thing crazy. It's down here for you.
Yes.
You can see it right there. Hi, guys. Welcome to AMC Thursday Ticket. We are so excited to be here. We were just chatting about how great of fans you guys are. You know, in like some forums, like people tend to get mad about winners, but not you guys. You guys congratulate other winners. So I just want to say how much we love you guys, and we are so glad that you are here.
Yeah, and we also love Harrison Ford, who has a new movie coming out this weekend called Call of the Wild.
Harrison Ford has been doing movies for more than six decades, right?
Yeah, and like TV shows in the 70s. He's been around forever.
Oh my gosh, I think I counted more than 58 movie appearances or cameos.
Yeah, but we want to know what your favorite Harrison Ford franchise is, and you can tell us in the comments below. So Kelley, I'm going to ask you first, what is your favorite Harrison Ford franchise?
Well, quick backstory. I know you guys are real surprised that I've got a quick backstory for you. I got to go to Disneyland's Star Wars Galaxy Edge recently and ride the Rise of the Resistance ride. And it just completely solidified my Star Wars geekdom. So, as you can imagine, Star Wars is my favorite Harrison Ford franchise.
Yeah, I mean, Harrison Ford is really the biggest part of Star Wars. He's my favorite character is Han Solo, and really made the final chapter of Star Wars come home for
just
me.
Great.
Yes.
Just fantastic. Now, don't forget that you guys got to put it in the comments what your favorite is. But Ryan, while they are working on typing, you tell us what's your favorite franchise.
I am dedicated to Steven Spielberg. He is my hero, my cinema god. So I have to go with Indiana Jones. My Harrison Ford is Jonesy.
Dr.
Jones. Yeah, it's so good. And they just announced that they are filming Indiana Jones 5. Spielberg is back. Hopefully we don't have any monkeys and aliens in this one, but I'm really, really excited about it.
It's going to be fantastic. So that's great. But we need to get to talk about this week's movie. So let's get started with our weekend movie guide.
I'm so excited about this movie.
It's going to be bigger than life.
Yes, and it's a dog movie. I love these films. I'm a sucker for like Marley and Me and Fox and the Hound. What is your favorite kind of dog-themed movie?
I'm a fox. I'm a hound dog. I love it. I know you guys are real surprised. My favorite dog movie. That is a good one because there's so many good ones out there.
I think for me as a kid, going back to the big gigantic dogs is Beethoven.
Oh, I forgot about that one.
Beethoven is Beethoven. So good.
He's so sweet.
But let's get into this one. This weekend, you can go see Call of the Wild. Reminds me a little bit of like a White Fang. Go into the mountains, into the wilderness. And it's based on a book.
Yeah, this one, I think it's from 1903-ish.
Wow.
Maybe?
Yeah. Dust that one off.
I know, right? And we all had to read it in English class, right? But this is a classic Jack London novel. It's been remade like probably 22 times or something. I don't know. You guys can fact check me. But this is going to be fantastic. It's about this dog who has lived so many different lives. And he has lived lives of luxury. And he's lived out in the wild, obviously, with Jack Thornton, our title character. But if you remember the book from your middle school or high school English classes, you remember that the beginning of it's a little rough. You know, there's a little bit of trauma to the dog in the beginning, and it can be hard to read. I just want to put your minds at ease that this is a very family-friendly movie, and it is rated PG, and they allude to it a little bit, but it is not going to traumatize your children forever, right?
Yeah, like every other dog movie in ever existence.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about this one. But, you know, as somebody with a daughter, we've been starving for family movies. We got Sonic last week, and this week you can take the kids, feel safe, and go see Harrison Ford in Call of the Wild.
Now, one of the things that I'm really excited about for this movie is since it's really about being at the edge of the earth, right? The scenery is just spectacular. And it's one of those that you really need to see on the big screen. So we have you don't have to even listen to it from us. We actually have a video with the cast that are going to tell us a little bit about that scenery and the filming of this movie. So watch it here.
A movie like this deserves to be seen in a good theater. I think there's something special that happens when you go into a dark room with strangers and they turn out the lights and they turn up the music and you are transported. And I think that that experience reinforces our common humanity. The majesty of nature deserves to be seen under the best circumstances. So I urge people to go to theaters. To see this kind of film.
I hope that people walk away with a sense of magic and wonder and the beauty of nature, that anything is possible. I hope people feel inspired.
Yeah, because I think the movie is a great adventure, it's a great journey. I think people will travel with the movie and also will take some notes about the beauty of our Earth and ourselves, you know, and we have also everything inside. I hope people will take that.
It is the natural world that sustains us. Nature doesn't need people. People need nature. We're not above nature. We're a part of nature. Until we recognize and are successful in allowing nature to provide benefit for humanity, we're not going to be able to be successful on this planet.
We could go, you and I,
where no one's ever been before. See what's out there.
You've been sleeping for 2 days.
In my bed.
Wow, that is beautiful.
Does that give you goosebumps?
Yes, I cannot wait to go on an adventure in the mountains with Harrison Ford.
I love to hear what he said about how nature doesn't really need us, but we really need nature. And it's just beautiful. And I can't wait to see this one.
Yeah.
It's going to be so fun. And like you said, I really have been craving some good family-friendly movies. So this has been great couple weekends for me.
And we want to take care of your family with a $40 gift card. All you have to do is answer some trivia for us in the comments below.
Whoa, I hope you're watching live. A $40 gift card.
Yeah.
That'll get a lot of chili dogs.
So this is not the only time we've seen this story on the big screen. But we want to know who played John Thornton, Harrison Ford's character, in the 1972 version of Call of the Wild?
1972. So not the 1935 version.
No.
Not the 2009 version.
Not the made-for-TV version.
None of that. Yeah. We want 1972 John Thornton actor.
Yes. So, a very, very significant actor
played
this role.
And leave it in the comments, because later in the show, we are going to draw a winner for that $40 gift card that you can use for whatever you want at AMC Theaters.
Yes. So family films have been big not only this weekend, but last weekend too, when Sonic the Hedgehog set box office records and being the highest grossing video game film on an opening weekend.
Sonic is so fun.
Yes.
Like, I don't know what you were doing last weekend.
I was watching Sonic.
But I pulled out my Sega Genesis and I played some Green Mile, because I'm not really that good, so that's the only level I can get to. And then I went to see Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yes, I absolutely loved this movie. My daughter loved this movie. She was running around the house like crazy, saying go fast like Sonic. I have to see it again, because not only am I a Sonic fan, I'm a video game fan. I've been playing those games since Genesis. I also love Jim Carrey. Oh, yeah. So that's another funny thing that my daughter did. She took my wedding ring and actually lost it in our house because she needed a Sonic ring to play with.
Yeah, so, I like your daughter. Yeah.
Thanks, Sophie. Yeah. But Jim Carrey, I'm a huge Jim Carrey fan, and he is finally back. I feel like this is the Liar Liar Jim Carrey, the Ace Ventura Jim Carrey, the Mask Jim Carrey that everybody has been waiting to see. So if you've not seen Sonic, but if you have seen Sonic, go see it again, add on to those box office dollars, and keep setting records for video game movies, because we were tired of when Uwe Boll was making these movies and challenging to fight critics when he's making Blood Rain and stuff like that.
I hear you're a little excited about Mortal Kombat coming up, too.
I am so excited. Not only I love the first Mortal Kombat movie, but I'm really, really excited about this brand new Mortal Kombat movie. Big Ed Boon fan, big Mortal Kombat fan. Cannot wait. I love video games.
We've got some great family movies out, and I hope that you are looking up, doing all your googly skills to look up the answer to that trivia question so that you can make it out. But if the family-friendly one isn't really your style, we got some other great movie coming out, too.
Yeah, I mean, how many horror movies have come out in February? It's insane. But now, this weekend, is Brahms the Boy 2. It has everything, and Kate Hudson is back.
Oh, Katie Holmes.
Oh,
Katie
yeah.
Holmes
Kate
is back.
Holmes, yes, sorry.
But this is some creepy stuff, and we actually have a clip here, so you don't need to hear it from us. Why don't you take a look at this clip here so you can see this creepy factor?
Sorry. I didn't know you were standing there. Why are you wearing that? Dinner's at 15.
So creepy.
Dial the creep factor up to 11 on that one.
It has everything. It's got your paranormal. It's got your creepy kid, like Children of the Corn. And then, like,
nope.
The creepy doll, like Puppet
nope.
Master.
Nope.
Every,
nope.
Yeah,
nope.
Just a whole bunch of nope.
A whole bunch of nope.
So take your loved one so you can hold them so tight and watch The Boy 2 is mandatory viewing for horror fans.
Absolutely. Now, that's not all we've got. We have some funny movies coming, too,
yeah.
In Impractical Jokers.
You may have seen this on True TV. It's so addicting. Like, you watch 40 episodes and then realize it's like past 3 hours. So it's finally time for these guys to get their own movie. And you can see this in a Fathom Event style.
And these are the crazy guys that, like, they put the earbuds in their friends' ears and, like, make them say crazy things,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's like my favorite part of the show. So they'll go in and the guys are trying to tell them, like, you have to drop this word in there. And if you do that, then you win a bet and stuff. So it's the dynamic between the guys is so good.
So are you a prankster?
I am not a prankster. Are you a prankster?
No, but
somebody needs to teach us.
I could be a prankster if you guys could leave me your best prank you've ever pulled in the comments, because I feel like I need to learn. And it's like just part of getting ready for the movie, right?
Yeah.
I got to learn some pranks.
So what are the best pranks that you've pulled? Let us know.
Now, this movie is opening in 175 theaters across the country. So make sure you check your app so that you'll know where it's going to be near you. Now, we have one more movie that we got to talk about in our weekend movie guide.
I'm really, really excited about this.
It looks hilarious. It's called Las Pedoras de Mi Novio.
My boyfriend's meds.
Boyfriend's meds, yes. And this is why one of your favorite studios,
yeah,
right?
It's a Pantaleon film. It's a romantic comedy, which I'm a sucker for romantic comedies. And this one looks great. It's about a guy who has everything going for him. He gets his dream girl, but he's keeping it all together by being on every medication in the world.
Because why wouldn't you be?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, everybody needs it. So he goes to an all-inclusive resort with this woman, but guess what? Forgets the medication, ends up dressed like a cowboy running around in his underwear.
And this girl, she thinks that he is just the bee's knees too,
yeah,
right? Who says that, the bee's knees? apparently me. And this, you guys, we watched this trailer earlier just to, you know, as a little refresher. At amctheaters.com, you can see the trailer too. And we were literally laughing out loud and rolling on the floor for this one because it was just that funny. There's so much, there's physical humor, there's mental humor. It's just so fun to watch. So go check out the trailer and then go to amctheaters.com and also check out where it's going to be playing near you, because this is going to be a great one.
Yeah, and don't forget to get your tickets. But let's hear about this trivia winner. So do you remember what the trivia question was?
I do remember what the trivia question was. It was something about how many movies have been made from Call of the Wild?
Close.
No,
there was
that wasn't
so
it.
Many. we wanted to know who else has played John Thornton, but specifically
John Thornton's the dog?
Harrison Ford's character.
Oh, Harrison Ford's character,
but
right.
But specifically in the 1972 version, and the winner is Jeff Schwartz, but
Jeff Schwartz, congratulations!
He knew that Charlton Heston was originally cast in that film.
That's great. Good job. I hope that was just some knowledge that you had and not your Googling skills. But either way, congratulations. I hope that you really enjoy taking your family this weekend to see Call of the Wild and getting some fun concessions to go along with your movie.
I love independent movies.
Oh my gosh.
I'm crazy about them. And this is my favorite segment. Let's get into some artisan films.
Our favorite artisan film of last year, technically.
Oh my gosh, my favorite movie of last year was Parasite. It is a film that never sees the IMAX screen, but this weekend you can see the best film of 2019 on our biggest screens in IMAX.
Now, I know it's hard. There's a lot of movies out there, and I talked to a lot of people that were like, oh, the Oscars were the first time I heard of Parasite. Now, it's okay. We'll forgive you if you're one of those people, but this is your chance to get out and see it. This is your chance in IMAX. It's going to be super limited engagement, so maybe 1, maybe 2 weeks. So make sure that you get your tickets now so that you can not be one of those people any longer.
Yeah, so don't, like Bong Joon-ho said when he won the Oscar, do not let subtitles hold you back from fantastic films. And this is a really, really great opportunity for independent cinema fans out there. Movies like this don't come to IMAX. You don't get to see them on the biggest screens. So take advantage and make sure that you see Parasite. But that's not all. Neon made Parasite, and they also have another movie coming out this week called The Lodge, which is a psychological thriller about a stepmom who's out in a cabin with her newly acquired stepchildren, and crazy things start happening.
I think this story happened to me just a few weeks ago in our last
episode. Oh, no. So you had like poltergeists like moving things around your house. And
that's what it felt like.
That is the worst snowed in time ever.
Oh, my gosh. Another horror film. This is the year of, or at least a quarter of horror films for all you horror film lovers out there. But we've got another one, too. The Assistant.
Yes. This, everybody is talking about this movie. It's super limited right now, but we really need you to go and support these movies so they become wider and they come to the theater near you. But I'm really, really excited about this movie. It's slightly based on what happened with the Weinstein situation. So it's very, very interesting. You have to go see this trailer. It's from Bleecker Street, who is an amazing studio producing amazing movies, and this is another one of them.
And this actress, she just puts on a great performance. This is it's like a thriller almost, the way that they present it, and this the psychological like drama that happens. So definitely go check out that trailer. See if it's coming to a theater near you. We have another super limited engagement that you're really excited about.
Another one. It's a subtitled film, so do not let that stop you. This is one of the best movies of the year. Everybody is talking about A Portrait of a Woman on Fire.
And this one's in French, right?
Yes, it's a French film, but don't let that stop you. It's such a good movie. If you're into independent cinema and love stories about independent women, then this is your go-to. It's a period piece about a woman who doesn't want to be married off, and her mom is trying to marry her off to this guy, and he needs to see a picture of what she looks like. So in order to do that, the mom hires a woman to secretly paint her, but it turns out the woman and her daughter fall in love. So it's a beautiful love story.
So it's like the medieval version of Tinder?
Yeah, you gotta send that portrait to swipe right. The guy has to see what she looks like.
Oh my gosh, so funny. This one, it does. It looks really beautiful and really great love story, and I'm really excited to see this one. This one is a limited engagement, only about like 15 theaters, I think, but it will open wider in March. So make sure that you're checking your app, setting those reminders and notifications on amctheaters.com so that you can get your tickets as soon as it's close to you. And our last artisan film is Emma. Now, if you remember, again, back to your high school reading list, Jane Austen wrote this book. Now, this one is only going to be in one theater, and that's at Lincoln Square 13 in New York City. So if you're in the New York area, you're going to get a chance to see this early. They've taken a few creative liberties with the story on this one,
but
it is funny.
Yes, and everybody is talking about the cinematography in this one. The colors are so vibrant. It's such a beautiful movie. But don't get discouraged, because it's not just going to be in New York. This thing is going to come out wider, too.
Absolutely. Now, I know it's your favorite part of the show now, so let's get right to it so you guys can hear about our exclusive offers this week. Now, if you're just tuning back in, remember that we gave away that $40 gift card to Mr. Jeff Schwartz. So congratulations, Jeff. We're really excited for you. But we also have another great offer with Call of the Wild.
Yeah. So if you buy tickets right now and see Call of the Wild during opening weekend, you're going to be entered into a sweepstakes to go on a Rocky Mountain adventure on a train. So not only can you see these beautiful mountains in the film, you get to go on a train and experience this with your family. Just no dogs.
I am in.
Yes.
I will be
Who
there.
Who wouldn't be in? It is the best way not only to experience Call of the Wild, but hey, you get this amazing opportunity that goes with it. So just make sure you're a Stubbs member and buy those tickets.
And you can answer your Call of the Wild.
Yay!
No, that was a bad joke. Don't laugh at that. The other offer that we have this week is a concession offer, actually.
Yeah.
So as we're going into our weekend of family-friendly movies, you can go see Sonic the Hedgehog before Sunday. You've got to get your tickets before Sunday to get the offer. And you'll get an icy and a popcorn, all for just $5. That's like almost an unbeatable deal.
Yeah, and your kids get to have the blue tongue for Sonic and have so much sugar that they'll be running around all over the theater.
Maybe not all over the theater, yeah. But regardless, they will love it. They will love their blue tongues and their red tongues, whatever icy flavor you love. So don't forget to get your tickets on our app and look at the bottom of your confirmation so that you can get that coupon too.
So
that's our show.
Yeah. Next week, though, Invisible Man, more horror.
So what? Another horror movie?
Yes.
How many does that make for this year?
You are asking me the wrong question.
I think seven? I think Matt's telling me it's eight.
Eight.
Can someone fact check him, please? Because I'm not sure I believe him.
But I'm really, really excited about this because I'm a huge Universal Monsters fan, and The Invisible Man comes from there, and Universal Studios has been trying to reboot this franchise, and they've finally done it with The Invisible Man. This is my most anticipated movie of the year.
This is one that even I'm going to be out to see because it looks so good.
Yes.
Like a true, like, scare you psychological thriller. I am very excited for this. Next week, they are also going to be talking about...
It's an anime film. So all you anime fans out there, My Hero Academia is here. So you get... Everybody's always asking, when is the next anime movie coming? It is next week. So you can go see it at an AMC theater.
That's going to be great. And I'm so glad that they're getting a good following like this. So tune in next week so that you can get to hear them talk about those two great movies. Don't forget to head over to YouTube so that you can see all the latest and greatest trailers. I know that some of you were kind of like, hey, I don't know what that movie is. What are they talking about? Well, you can check it out too on YouTube for trailers. You can also follow us on Twitter. I know today was super fun because they were doing a tell us about your day in a Harrison Ford GIF. That made me laugh a lot. So go check that out because it was just a lot of fun.
Yeah. Thank you all for posting the Blade Runner GIFs. Those were my favorite. But you can also find all of our movie news on Twitter. If you want to stay most up to date, follow us on Twitter. And make sure that you share and set notifications for the show. Make all your family and friends watch us because we appreciate you.
We have such a good time hanging out with you guys every Thursday. So if you guys also have a good time, make sure that your friends know too so that they can join in the fun, join in the conversation. That's it, Ryan.
Oh,
that's all
we
got.
I had such a good time.
Me too. You guys have been great, and we are so excited to see you next Thursday. So get out to the movies, and we'll see you then.
See you at the theater.